March. Cars. Halt. Left. Face. Freeze. Head. Arms.
We are facing a unique time in the history of our nation. I'm sure that's the way our brothers and sisters, mothers and fathers, and next door neighbors felt when they were called to arms to defend our country, to defend those liberties and freedoms they fought hard for us. Many lost their lives in those battles. Others were wounded, came home crippled. Memorial Day was established so that we, the living, would never forget the sacrifices those who gave their last full measure of devotion. We had little choice this year but to cancel our community Memorial Day parade, but we couldn't let this solemn holiday pass without giving the people an opportunity to stop, even if only for 30 minutes, to reflect on those lives given and those sacrifices made over the years. Thank you for joining us today. We look forward to seeing you next year back at Veterans Memorial Courtyard on the square in Carlisle.
Gracious and Heavenly Father, in the precious name of Jesus, Lord God, once again you have allowed us to assemble ourselves together to remember Memorial Day and all those men and women of the armed forces who made the ultimate sacrifice for our country. Father God, as we pause to say thank you and to remember, we ask that you continue to walk with us, continue to bless this country as only you can. Father God, to watch over each one. In Jesus' precious name we pray, amen.
We're pleased to have as our Memorial Day speaker today, Congressman Scott Perry. The congressman is a combat veteran, former Army aviator, and a retired Brigadier General with nearly 40 years of military service. He's represented the 715,000 citizens of the 10th and the former 4th Congressional District of Pennsylvania since 2013. He has served in the U.S. House Committee on Homeland Security and presently serves on the Committees on Transportation and Infrastructure and Foreign Affairs. He served in the Pennsylvania General Assembly for 6 years. He has a bachelor's degree in business from Penn State University and a master's degree in strategic studies from the U.S. Army War College. Congressman Perry resides in Dillsburg with his wife, Christy, and their two children. Congressman Perry.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it is certainly my high honor, my privilege to be here with you in Carlisle today on this Memorial Day. And of course, this maybe you might not realize, but has special meaning for me as I served some of my time in the military in uniform right here at this location, right here at the mighty 108th. And I'm so proud to stand here before you on this Memorial Day. Yeah, this is 150 years, over 150 years of remembering those who made all this possible, who make all this possible. It is not the people that write the newspapers. It's not politicians who make policy. It's not people out on the job working every day. It is people that have been willing to put their lives on the line, to pledge their lives, their fortunes, their sacred honor, and give their last full measure, that make all of this possible. And every day while we enjoy our freedoms and live our lives, not thinking about the price and the cost of freedom, going about our day carelessly, walking out the front door in the bright sunshine, someone paid for that. Someone paid for that. And so this day, on this day in particular, is important that we acknowledge and that we remember that the cost of freedom is very, very dear. And someone paid it for us. Someone made that ultimate sacrifice on our behalf and the freedom of our nation. And so it is entirely fitting at this location, at this time, on this day, to remember and spend time thinking about those who have provided so much for us and the free world. And so I just encourage you all to take a moment today to think about that and to honor the sacrifices of our nation's veterans and those who have borne the battle. And with that, I grant you Godspeed, and God bless you all, and God bless America.
All about, and those caissons go rolling along. For it's high, high gear, shores of Tripoli. We will fight our country's battles in the air, on land and sea. First we fight for right and freedom, and to keep our honor free. We are proud to claim the title of United States of America. Our name, Navy, Coast Guard, Air Force, the United States of America.
A long-standing tradition of this ceremony is the reading of the Roll of Honor, the roll call of those Carlisle area veterans who died between May 1st, 2019 and this April 30th. Rex B. Aston, Korea. John E. Bachowski, Vietnam. Chester B. Belucky, World War II in Korea, John Eugene Boland Sr., and James Mark Brodigam, both Vietnam, Robert L. Brownowell, Korea, John H. Buchenauer, Wayne B. Senderland, Carl R. Codner, and Roger L. Danzison, all Vietnam, Richard T. Dunn, and John L. Dernan, World War II, Hugh B. Dierman, Korea, Melvin Eugene Flanagan, World War II, Korea and Vietnam, Edward J. Gardner and George Fisher Gardner, both World War II, David L. Garland and John M. Gasper Sr., Vietnam, Edward J. Gatton Sr., Jimmy C. George, John F. Gibson and Thomas Gimple, William H. Grove, all Korea, Robert Hugh Hamill, World War II, Clark B. Heffelfinger Jr., Korea, Charles Carl Heppner, Korea and Vietnam, Austin B. Hertzler III, Richard A. Holmes, both Vietnam, Philip J. Hunsinger Jr., World War II, John Robert Johnston and Paul R. Jones, both Korea, George H. Jumper, World War II, John David Keeney Jr., Korea and Vietnam, John F. Kelso Jr., Robert Harrison Lamp, World War II, Henry W. Langley, and Robert P. Liebram, both Korea, Barry L. Lloyd, Vietnam, Andrew Long, Korea and Vietnam, Maurice A. Lynch, World War II, Ronald Lyons, Vietnam and Persian Gulf, Thomas Leo Lyons, Korea and Vietnam, J.W. McBride, Sr., Korea, William H. McClure, World War II, George Gary Malseed, Vietnam, Donald Clark Manbeck, Korea and Vietnam, Edward W. Metesky Sr., World War II, John Franklin Meehan III, Bruce E. Miller, and Raymond D. Miller, all Vietnam, Joseph Robert Murray Jr., Korea, Harry W. Nicholson, Paul Franklin Orr, both Vietnam, James W. Peffer, World War II, Richard R. Pinto, Vietnam, Carl L. Rodabaugh, Korea, Kent Robert Rentschler, John E. Riley, Robert G. Robb, Victor L. Rogoski Jr., Edward George Roscoe, all Vietnam, Donald O. Reinhard and John F. Schorsch, both Korea, Jacob Shealy Jr. and Raymond H. Shoemaker, both World War II, Joseph D. Spinelli Sr., World War II, Korea, Vietnam, William M. Stoops Jr. and Rodney E. Throne, Korea, Jerry Ulmer, Vietnam, Charles Wayne Van Beber, Persian Gulf, Elmer R. Warner Jr., Korea, Samuel Lester Weaver, Korea and Vietnam, Clinard Ray Witten, Vietnam, John Taggart Ziegler, World War II, Cosmo Joseph Ziegler, Zizzy Sr., World War II, Korea and Vietnam. The individual graves displayed during the reading of the roll were selected because of those whose final resting places they are. Mary Hayes McCauley is better known as Molly Pitcher. She is recognized for her bravery during the Revolutionary War. When her husband was injured, she picked up his ramrod and continued firing the cannon. General John Armstrong was the first colonel commissioned in the Continental Army, and he established the 1st Rifle Battalion. A portion of the Ashland Cemetery is considered an official United States military cemetery. In September 1878, the government reinterred 500 unknown Civil War casualties, apparently from a cemetery in Maryland. Only 35 were identified, the rest known but to God. Sergeant Jacob Card is buried there. The Civil War Medal of Honor recipient was cited. His citation reads for capture of the flag of the 19th Georgia Infantry, wresting it from the hands of the color barrier during the Battle of Fredericksburg. Captain William Miller received the Medal of Honor for disobeying an order during the Battle of Gettysburg. Told to hold his position, he instead ordered his squadron out of the woods, successfully stopping the forward movement of the Confederate Army. Charles Seabold is buried in the old graveyard. He was a drummer with the 1st U.S. Cavalry. He died within 2 months of his enlistment. Staff Sergeant John Minnick received his Medal of Honor while serving in the Army during World War II. He was cited for his actions during the Battle of Hurtgen Forest. Sergeant First Class Randall Sugart was with the U.S. Army's Special Ops Unit, Delta Force. He was posthumously awarded the Medal of Honor for his heroic actions and sacrifice during the Battle of Mogadishu in October of 1993. Lance Corporal Edric Hosky was killed while fighting the enemy during his return from a patrol to Da Nang, South Vietnam, on August 18, 1966. His remains have never been recovered. A military stone has been placed in his honor at Cumberland Valley Memorial Gardens. We would be remiss if we didn't mention Lincoln Cemetery. Throughout the 19th century, hundreds of African Americans were buried there, including members of the 54th and 55th Massachusetts Infantry Regiment, the first black soldiers allowed to fight in the U.S. Army during the Civil War. Also, 3 World War I soldiers were buried there. The area was transitioned to a park. While tombstones are gone, those buried there remain there.
And now to him who is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before God Almighty, to the one and only true God, in Jesus' name, and as we depart from here, but not from your presence, we thank you and we praise you. Amen.
Thank you.
Christ. Thanks. Lord, Arch.